Welcome to Celebrations!
Good evening, dear viewers all over the world.
We are so glad to be with you this evening.
We are now on the seventh episode of our series, and I know all of us are blessed by the messages we have heard for the past night.
If you missed the previous episodes, don't worry. You can watch it anytime and anywhere. Just visit our Facebook page, Naga View Adventist College Media Ministries. And don't forget to like, follow, and share our page to get notification of our live streaming.
Partner, katulad ng sabi mo, nasa kalagitnaan na tayo ng ating series. So far, ano experience mo?
And ako partner, I'm so blessed each time na nakikinig ako ng ating mga episodes because talagang napapanahon siya.
Mm-mm, tama ako din. Marami akong na-realize sa mga messages na narinig natin na actually ito ay dati pa eh. Narinig na natin pero nakakalimutan natin, hindi natin ginagawa. So now, we are being reminded of these healthy messages, lalo pa na pandemic ngayon, meron tayong COVID-19, so all of us gusto natin maging safe and healthy.
Indeed. Kaya naman, this is our question for tonight's episode. How can we still be healthy even if we are staying in cities where we are prone to polluted air? The comment section is now open.
Huwag niyo pong kalimutang banggitin ang inyong pangalan at lugar upang kayo ay aming ma-recognize. At baka kayo na ang maswerte mapipili namin na makakatanggap ng surprise gift.
True partner, kaya huwag na natin itong patagalin pa because I am sure our dear viewers are excited as well. Before we introduce our speaker tonight, we will hear first an instrumental rendition by Daniel Paloma.
Let us all be blessed as we listen to the music.
Thank you.
Thank you for that beautiful instrumental. Now, partner, sino ba yung mga kasama natin ngayong gabi?
Alam mo, partner, we are privileged kasi kasama natin live sa ating studio ang ating speaker.
Mm-hmm.
Our speaker is a graduate of Bachelor of Science in Nursing, batch 1978 at Philippine Union College, now Adventist University of the Philippines. She was the former school nurse and guidance counselor of our very own school, Naga View Adventist College. Our speaker tonight is Mrs. Melgie Venida Paez. Hello, ma'am.
Hello. I'm happy to be invited here.
Wow.
Kami din po ay nagagalak sapagkat kasama po namin kayo live dito po sa ating studio.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Okay. So, ma'am, meron po kami ilang mga katanungan dito upang lubos po naming maunawaan, lalo po ng ating mga viewers, patungkol po sa ating topic. Okay, so handa na po ba kayo, ma'am?
Okay.
Okay. So ito po ang unang katanungan namin sa inyo. What are the objectives of knowing about this topic, which is air?
Okay. The objectives of knowing about this topic, air, is to know the importance of breathing clean, fresh air.
Mm-hmm.
Another is to understand the detrimental effects of breathing polluted air outside and inside. And another is, in order for us to learn how to breathe deeply using our diaphragm.
Wow, okay. So, yun po pala yung magiging objective natin sa ating pag-aaral ngayong gabi. Okay?
So, ngayon po ma'am, bakit mabigat na usapin po ang pagtatalakay nitong topic natin about air?
Ah, it is a heavy subject because, you know, our body needs the most important element, which is oxygen. Although air is composed of only about 20% of oxygen, its inhalation brings about this life-sustaining gas into the lungs. Oxygen then diffuses into the bloodstream via diffusion. And then from the bloodstream, it will be circulated and distributed to the different cells and tissues of our body.
Okay, so yun pala. Ngayon ma'am, ang aming pong sunod na tanong ay, dahil po importante po pala talaga itong air sa atin, do 20% nga lang po, pero talagang ito po yung buhay po natin, no, bilang tao. Now, gusto po naming malaman, ma'am, pwede po bang bigay pa po kayo sa amin ng mga information about air, which is it is one of God's gift po.
Yes, very true. It is one of God's gift to man. Air is truly a gift of God, and we cannot live long without air. From the book Wind and Wellness, it says you can live 4 to 6 weeks without food, and perhaps 5 to 7 days without water, but only minutes without air. And that air contains the oxygen, which is the life-giving oxygen in our body.
So, grabe po, isang minuto lang. Kaya mo bang pigilin, partner, yung hininga mo?
Siguro 10 seconds di ko na kaya. Parang hihinga din na.
Maximum na po yun, ma'am?
Not,
1 minute.
Not really 1 minute, mm-hmm, but few minutes, mm-hmm, maybe.
Talagang total, shutdown na po yung body.
Yes. Wala na po. Parang, wala, patay ka na talaga. Ganun po. So, ito po ma'am na next na tanong ko. Kasi bata pa po ako, elementary pa lang, ay lagi na po sinasabi na dapat malinis na hangin yung ating nilalanghap. So, ano po ba ma'am ang effect ng paglanghap ng clean and fresh air?
Okay. Clean and fresh air is really very important because, you know, when we take in or inhale clean, fresh air, it will help us improve our sense of well-being. It increases rate and quality of growth in plants and animals, and improves functions of the lungs' protective cilia. It decreases anxiety. Mm-hmm. It lowers body temperature. Mm-hmm. It lowers resting heart rate. Mm-hmm. Decreases survival of bacteria and viruses in the air, and improves learning. It also decreases severity of stomach ulcers.
So yun pala yung kahalagahan kung bakit natin kailangan maglanghap ng malinis.
We are privileged din talaga na nandito tayo sa Naga View. Magandang environment talaga for learning, healing.
Fresh air talaga dito. Daming puno. Ayan. So hindi polluted. Now ma'am, dahil po doon na kailangan pala talaga nating lumanghap ng sariwa at malinis na hangin, ano naman po yung benefits po ng paglanghap or paghinga po natin yung breathing deeply ng fresh air?
Okay, the benefits of breathing deeply of clean, fresh air is we sleep better. You know, when in the evening, when you are going to sleep, you can open the window so that there would be good ventilation. So you will have a restful night. And then it helps us more to be optimistic. And we perform better athletically. And then we are more pleasant to live with when we dip clean, fresh air, when we breathe clean, fresh air, and we think more clearly.
Okay, so
those
yun
po are the benefits of breathing
sa ating
deeply
ulos.
Of fresh air.
Opo. Super holistic.
Ating pagtulog. Ayan,
kaya pala importante. Siguro, hindi ako nakakatulog ng maayos kasi sa dorm. Oo, lagi kong sinasarado kasi natatakot po kami. So, simula siguro mamayang gabi,
ako din,
i-open
dapat,
ko na para
open the windows.
Para,
okay, so mas kaya, maganda po na kung may screen man, diba? So, para protected pa rin. Pero yung kurtina, pwedeng buksan para makapasok yung hangin. Ano po? Okay.
So, eto ma'am, gusto ko din po itong itanong kasi usually pag may mga nahihimatay, sabihin nila na, ay kulang kasi yan sa hangin. So, ano po yung magandang gawin natin para maingatan natin, or what is the best thing we can do for our brain?
Oh, it's simple. We need to exercise. That's the answer. Because when we do exercise, you see, there is a rapid breathing. Mm-hmm. And so with the rapid breathing, deep breathing, there is a fast exchange of oxygen getting inside and carbon dioxide going outside of our body. So every cell is nourished with oxygen and then being released with carbon dioxide.
Ayun, that pala talaga partner, mag-exercise tayo. Laro-laro, galaw-galaw para daw hindi ma-stroke. Yeah. Tama po pala yun.
Malaking tulong din talaga kasi
exercise.
Mas nakakahinga po.
Yeah, I think it was already discussed in
the previous nights.
Yes, okay.
So, sa susunod po naming tanong, ma'am, paano naman po tayo matutulungan ng deep breathing? Or ano po ba yung tinatawag na diaphragmatic breathing?
Diaphragmatic breathing is actually using our diaphragm or our rib cage. This is how we are going to do it. You stand straight. Now that we are seated, then we will just demonstrate how are we going to put to make use of that diaphragmatic breathing. Okay. We extend our arms upward and then make a deep breath with your mouth closed. Closed mouth. And then, after you have done that deep breathing, you lower your arms and then exhale with your mouth open. With your mouth open. As much as possible. You can even cough it out so that the carbon dioxide will be taken out of your lungs. Okay. And there will be a good air exchange. Actually, we are advised to make it 5 to 10 times every morning. 5 to 10 times every morning. If we can do that, there will be good air exchange in our lungs.
Okay po. So, hindi po pala sa dibdib humihinga po, no? Diaphragm po?
Diaphragm. Ito, rib cage. Kinakailangang mag-expand so that there will be more air or oxygen that will get in.
Akala ko po, ano lang? Akala ko po sa lungs po humihinga. So, hindi po pala.
Sa lungs, yung alveoli sacs. Alveoli cells.
Siguro po yung normal breathing. Dito talaga.
Mababaw lang eh.
Pero dapat laging may ganun din para...
Okay. Actually, in quiet breathing, there are only 500 cubic centimeters of air or of oxygen that gets in and carbon dioxide. Or that means the air exchange is only 500 centimeters. Okay, 500 cubic centimeters, while in deep breathing or diaphragmatic breathing, there is 4,000 cubic centimeters, or that means 8 times greater than during quiet breathing.
Okay, so yun po pala sa diaphragmatic. Maalala ko, partner, ang diaphragmatic breathing ay nagagamit sa, pag nag-vocalization sa choir, o ano, dito po talaga eh, humihinga eh. Tapos yung inhale and exhale na, yung coughing po na sinabi nyo po kanina, ano. Okay.
Kaya nga, very important po talaga yung makabreathe tayo ng
deep breathing.
Clean and fresh air. Opo. So ano naman po yung mga detrimental effects of breathing polluted air?
Oh, there are a lot of detrimental effects. You know, many people are exposed to poor quality indoor air and outdoor air, and those are pollutants. And many workers develop fatigue, sore throats, difficulty of breathing, or difficulty of concentration, and some experience allergic reactions like symptoms. These sicknesses are known as sick building syndrome. So maraming nararamdaman. And these symptoms will be and are alleviated by good ventilation. So kung gusto nating hindi makaranas ng mga
sakit
na yon, ay magkaroon ng good ventilation.
Okay. So, dapat po talaga labas-pasok yung hangin. Aircon. Oh. Air continuous po.
Air continuous.
Hindi lang po yung masosuffocate ka na sa hangin na parang palitan na lang dito na lang umikot yung hangin. Ayun.
Actually, sa indoors, yung mga saradong lugar, maraming pollutants. Maraming pollutants kahit sa ating bahay. Ano yung mga pollutants na yon? They are mold spores, especially if you have bookshelf and then you have books and then it has been there for quite a long time and they were not dusted, it will accumulate mold spores. That's why yung mga naglilinis ng kanilang ng bookshelf, maraming inaasma dahil doon sa mga naging spores, mold spores, yung galing sa molds, and then dust mites and even airborne bacteria, They irritate our respiratory system and even breathing air contaminated by some of our household chemicals. Mm. What are those household chemicals? Yung mga sprays.
Opo,
pangpatay
po.
Ng
ipis.
Yung mga ginagamit natin paglilinis ng CR.
Magtapang po.
Oh, yung mga chemicals na yon. They are causing a lot of these indoor pollutants. And so that needs to be avoided. So kailangan nga kung maglilinis tayo ng CR, bukas ang CR para kung maggamit man tayo ng Sunrocks
or magmask po.
Oo, or magmask. Pero malaking tulong kung naka-open.
Open air, okay.
Dapat open air. Tapos dapat lagi ding maglinis talaga
maglinis ng bahay.
Oh. Kasi naku, baka yung ilalim ng mga bed minsan, taunan bago linisin.
Ayun. So how about ma'am yung cigarette smoking po? Ayun. Does it cause air pollution?
Ay, grabe. Yung smoke from the cigarettes. The cigarette smoke releases air pollutants and they goes into the atmosphere, and also cigarette butts, yung after smoking yung mga butts, they are also, they will go to the soil, and then it also releases toxic chemicals, and that goes into the soil causing soil and water pollution. And, you know, according to an Italian study, 3 cigarettes can cause more air pollution than a diesel car exhaust. Only 3 cigarettes being smoked will cause air pollution than a diesel car exhaust.
So mas malaki po talaga, mas delikado po talaga yung cigarette, yung usok sa sigarilyo po. Ano.
Yes, that is according to the Italian study.
Okay po. Okay, so partner, meron pa tayong huling tanong.
Yeah. Ma'am. I'm going to add more about these pollutants. Other common air pollutants that has health effects are, we learned that when we were in high school or in college, the carbon monoxide, nitrogen dioxide, ozone and particulates matter, lead and sulfur dioxide. And this have a lot of effects on our health.
How about pa yung ano po, pagsusunog po ng plastic or mga dahon? Ano naman po yun?
Actually, pinagbabawal nga ang magsunog.
Okay.
Kaya lang pipiliin natin yung bang eyesore.
Okay.
Minsan, but we really should be careful in burning those plastics, especially styrofoam, because it emits or releases a lot of these pollutants. Which are harmful to our body.
Opo. Kung minsan din po naamoy, nagsusunog ng gulong or goma. Iba
oo.
Po yun po.
Especially,
amoy din po yun.
Especially, I remember when I was still working at Manila Sanitarium and Hospital during New Year, December 31.
Ay, opo,
a lot of these tires are being burned on the streets. Mm. And then, in return, maraming dinadala sa ER
hospital
dahil sa naamoy nila yun, nasosuffocate, nagkakaroon ng asthmatic attack.
Okay, so ganun po, kadelikado yung air pollution sa atin naman po. Ano?
So ito po ma'am ay siguro last question na at marami na rin talaga kami natututunan. So ano naman po yung spiritual implication natin sa pag-aaral nitong topic natin about air?
Ah, magandang tanong yan. It says in John 3, Jesus likens new spiritual life to being born again by the Spirit. We cannot see the Spirit, but we can sense Him like we sense the air. And the Bible speaks of the Holy Spirit that is sustaining us. Just like the air or the oxygen, it sustains our physical body. So it is a must that we need to really breathe in clean air, which contains oxygen, and also the Holy Spirit to have to make our spiritual life strong.
Opo. Ayun po. So, no. Kailangan po talaga din natin ng spiritual breathing, hindi lang po yung hangin na hinihinga.
Ang gusto ko dun sa parang nabanggit din ni Ma'am, katulad daw ng hangin, hindi natin nakikita yung Panginoon, pero nararamdaman natin at importante yun. Sabi nga, may mga, yun sa mga kabataan, no? Sabi nila, ay, hindi ko kayang mabuhay na wala ka. Tapos sabi ng isa, ano, hangin? Ah, di ba? Kasi, ano mang bagay kaya nating mabuhay kahit walang
tubig ganun. Kanina.
Oo, pero pag walang hangin, wala, mahirap. Ganon din ang spiritual life natin naman pag wala ang Panginoon. Parang hindi mo.
Kulang. Hindi lang sa kulang, kundi talagang wala. Patay talaga tayo din.
So,
kinakailangan po natin talaga ng fresh air to breathe and the spiritual breathing natin. Ayun. So ma'am, maraming salamat po sa inyo pong ibinahagi sa amin ngayong gabi. Talagang siguradong ating mga viewers ay nabusog ng hangin, ng fresh air
at na-refresh sila.
Spiritual air ngayong gabi. Ayun po.
Thank you.
Hilingan po namin kayo ma'am ng closing prayer.
Okay, let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us the air that sustains our lives. Thank you, dear Lord, for the blessings that we receive from you each day, especially the air that we breathe every day. Dear Lord, thank you for these young people who are doing their best to produce this series so that all will be helped. We will be informed of the benefits of the different items like the air, the sunshine, the proper nutrition, exercise, and many more. Dear Lord, may we remain faithful to you till you come. Thank you for blessing us this evening, and thank you for hearing our prayers in Jesus' name.
Amen. Muli namin kayong inaanyayahan bukas ng gabi alas 6 upang mapakinggan na naman ang isang lekturang magbibigay sa atin ng impormasyon para mapanatili ang malusog at masiglang pamumuhay.
Maraming salamat, dear viewers, sa pagtutok ngayong gabi. Hanggang sa muli, I'm Rosanne Montealegre.
And I am Kimberly Joyce Marquez.
And this is Celebrations!